we, Ocala? Where are we, Ocala?
Hey folks, it's a rainy day here in Ocala, Florida, but we're here at the Don Garlits Museum of Drag Racing. So there's a lot of cool stuff in here. As you see from the father of drag racing, the Swamp Rat himself. Let's go check it out. All right, so we're in the legendary Don Garlits Museum right now. And there is just so much here, several buildings in here. He was pretty much the father of drag racing. Had just tons of championships, tons of winnings. He was instrumental in not creating, but finalizing or perfecting the rear engine dragster. Actually, because of an accident with his two-speed transmission he was building, that was a front dragster that took off part of his foot. So that was kind of instrumental in helping him get that stuff done. Seeing here. But you guys read that if you want to pause. This is a turbine dragster. Look at that. Two of them built this car at Sefner, Florida. General Electric T5810 gas turbine producing 1400 horsepower on kerosene. Top speed 219 miles an hour. That's pretty cool. A lot of drag racing history in this building. '77 car. I think he used 426 Hemis for most of his career. I think he got talked into one other motor for one season. Forget that what that was, but I'm sure we'll see it in here. That sequence, excellent. That's an ollie. Little scooter bikes from back in the day. Bad little scooter, not scooter, hang on. Bad little go-kart there. I don't know what that thing's powered by. Looks fast though. That's a gorgeous dragster. So everything in here is not just Garlits. This is the Museum of Drag Racing, so it's got a lot of notable people here. This was Garlits rail. Size of that trophy. Swamp Red 11. Still on the dragster. They never let him out. Can you imagine the sound if all these bad boys started up at once right now? Be deaf for life. This is probably, yeah, it is. This is Garlits' very first dragster that he formed out of a Model T back in the day. First dragster in 54, 55. I think this thing still did 13 seconds, and that was to ET. It was 12 actually. 12:10. Top speed 108. That's pretty wild. Crazy drag bike over here. These guys that ride these drag bikes are nuts. At least in a car, you got a cage around you. These things, you get squirrely or toast. Got some big kahunas, guys. A little bit of your petty stuff over here. Crazy looking ride there. A Piranha. Driver Walt Stevens. It's like a big old kit car dragster. Old bears and them old tires. AMT Piranha. Another gorgeous fiberglass one here. That's pretty. bet it was pretty wicked too. Setzer Butera 72 ton fuel dragster. Let's see over there. Cool beast. I like it a lot. Prep 4B. This one right here. That's a really cool model setup and breakdown. Says Godzilla. Swamp Rat number 25. Swamp Rat 24. Part blower. Oh, wonder if this one is this the one that no, because this is a rear engine one. That's not the one that took his foot. And I'm sure he had plenty of cars and motors and trannies come apart in his career. Just one did him serious damage to his poor little appendage. Little memorial, I guess, to his sister. That's sweet. Ooh, got a nice max wedge here. 62 max wedge. He raced this bad boy too. Dom for Dom car there. Cochran, Chris Karamisons, am I saying that right? Pete Robinson, Connie Kalita, Creets Green and Donovan, John, how you say that, Webb. Yes, I'm not a drag racing expert by any means. Do totally appreciate all this stuff though. These beasts are super cool. Roth's Yellow Fang, really. Ed Roth, that's a bad looking dragster. some reason the back of that dragster, the cockpit area, reminds me of when Beetlejuice guy stretched his head back when they were trying to look scary. I know, I'm weird. Maitland, Mr. Maitland. Got the Maitlands. That's who I'm trying to think of. Crazy early stuff. A flathead. A bug. 41 to 50. Another Model T dragster. This looks like it would be a salt flat car instead of a regular dragster. Designs in these old things. Chuck Jones Mag Wander. That's crazy. Mini funny car. Yeah, that's fitting. Pocket Rocket. I don't know what this thing is. Powered by. It's just a mini junior dragster that shoots. Crazy. So much cool memorabilia here too. Oh, Tom McGowan, Mongoose. Nice. That name I'm familiar with because I had a Hot Wheels of not this color, but you guys know what, the silver one. Flats car of some sort. Another swap rat. See, he had his hand and everything. So he did 220 in this car. Flats. About that, him severing his foot in that accident right here.
Garlits sets in motion one of drag racing's greatest revolutions, the dawn of the age of the rear engine top fuel car.
Steve, you know, this car is one of my favorites. If not the favorite, because this is the rear engine car. It's a needle nose thing from the front to the back. you stand in front of it and look at it, it looks right. It looks like it ought to be a race car.
This was the first contemporary rear-engine car that changed the sport.
Yes, it is. It's the first one that qualified at a national event and won the event.
I think the most frightening still photograph I've ever seen was of the clutch explosion in that front motor car lines. Had that explosion not happened, would the rear-engine dragster have evolved anyway without that accident on your part?
I think it would have. I just think that it would have been probably 3 or 4 years down the road. But sooner or later, somebody would have put one together, and the cars were getting longer and the clutches were getting right. This was one of the things that did help my development. The technology of the sport had come to a point where it was possible to do it. Of course, that became more so all the time. So what would have happened? There'd have been some more guys killed, and finally somebody would have said, look, I'm sick of this, I'm going to do it. And it would have happened. It just wouldn't have happened quite as fast. Because what makes something like that really take place is for somebody like the Snake or Tom McHugh and their Gary Beck or somebody, one of the front runners, to take a project and put their heart into it. And what was happening before was guys that weren't really that type of a racer were building the cars, and they were trying funny deals. Most of the teams, they weren't really conventional type cars. They were
Shirley will down the car.
Tommy and I both have the money and the time to spend both experimenting and racing. However, most people started out racing in funny cars because it was a lot cheaper than top fuel.
I bought a used funny car. Whipped piece of junk from Connie Coletta. And Jack Muldowney tuned his first nitro car. I ran quicker and faster than Coletta ever ran in it. And it was a heat. I run like a son of a gun. And I got my feet wet in funny car. Had a couple flyers with that.
In fact, there's only one Shirley Muldowney funny car left today. And it is here at the museum in Ocala, as all the others were destroyed in fires. Shirley eventually made the move up to top fuel and immediately proved that she belonged there for the big boys.
Shirley stands and shoulders above the crowd. She really, really brought the women into the sport, you know. It made a reason for the wife or the girlfriend to want to go to the tracks because there was Shirley.
Man, they got such wild designs in some of these things. Streamliners, they're called. Streamliner dragsters. Pretty.
Thank you.
Another Dom Perdom front engine dragster. There's one skinny rail. Funny car. U.S. Army funny car. Top speed 225. Dumper Dom dragster. Wedge dragster, that style's called. Wedge cheese ramp up the side. They're experimenting with all kinds of shapes to get the edge on aerodynamics. First rear engine car. Yep. Here you go, Larry Price. I know you love your Woolies. Collectively, how much horsepower is in this building, or these several buildings? Gotta be in the hundreds of thousands. Yeah. What's that black style called? I think it was like a French style Tupelo or something. Way off. Might be thinking of something else. I think it's that car though. What the heck? That can't be drivable. Pollutionizer. Allison V12. 2000. some horsepower.
Maybe a camera helmet or something. I think it doesn't look drivable. But there was a picture of a burnout over there. I don't know how the crap they saw on this thing. It's bad looking. First one-piece fiberglass bodied car of its kind. 2,000 horsepower V12 Allison aircraft engine. That's crazy. That thing's wicked cool. So is this beast. Both powered by V12 Allisons. Very cool. One Garlits Dart 2. Be the first one to break 200, I think. He broke a lot of firsts. Switch. Twin turbos in that bad boy. Cool. 10,000 horsepower rocket dragster. Twisted up swamp rat number 31. Flipped it over backwards on its sixth run in 1987. Tore her up. Thank you. grew wings.
Busted him all up. Looks like he came out okay though. Imagine taking flight at those speeds. Those are terrifying. That car, Jungle Jim. Jet funny car. Mustang, funny car. It says all but this one was destroyed by fire. And surely was burned seriously in one of the fires. Max. John Force car. At least a shell. There's no car under there. Cool old Dragster.
Disappointing for us on Friday night. We didn't have the success that we had hoped for. show is where we had to start on this, because we had to bring Don to the car and we had to bury these two together. And that doesn't happen in just one run. What he's done here is absolutely phenomenal, to take a car today and figure out how to drive it all in 2 days. And it started out a little rough for us, but I'll tell you what, this guy came back and hands down, he's a true driver.
Oh,
he
can
still compete.
I realize that.
We're gonna drag this.
Red.
I don't know what the switches are for.
Wheel red to clock reaction time.
What are all these on?
Single user. Two users. Full tree.
Handicap right there.
Left lane on.
No handicap. Perfect tree. What does that say? 500 second. Top bulb block.
I don't know what I'm supposed to press. Where's my gas pedal?
I think you're hitting the button for the. Hitting the red button for you.
Hold the red button on steering wheel. Release the red button to clock reaction time.
Okay, so you're staging by holding it.
You win.
Hold again. Racing.
You're kicking my ass.
Yeah, that's
about 10 minutes later, this long letter comes back.
That thing's wicked.
I can't believe I got an email.
Dual Buick engines.
Yes, that's just what I'm looking for. But I like it. I like
that thing's cool.
Just as much as I like it, because I guess.
I said I think the steering was too fast. I said, but that can't be it.
Look at all the badass beasts in here. I actually have that one. I get a little Hemi. Got a couple of little Hemis. Cool cutaways. If I'm not mistaken, I think Tim Wilburn might have had that one in his collection. Or maybe it was Giuliano. Maybe there's more than one of them. Chrysler cutaway of 440. How cool is that?